It's getting so I'm wasting my breath when I talk to these imbeciles on the computer and they're attacking me with weapons and trying to run my life. There are famous people with very big names that have this club that talk to me every day, and they attack me with weapons that tonight they're burning my chest, and earlier today I couldn't take a breath. And they're telling me online it's because I posted something about Christ, and then they're telling me because I said something good about Russia. And what kills me is these men gang me as soldiers and kill me with these weapons that are high grade that you would think would be used on your enemy, like military enemy, not a woman alone in her own bed at night, dreaming. These are imbeciles. These are just demons. And the demons have taken over these people in this country. They're all a bunch of lunatics, a bunch of fools. And so today they're saying, well, your pain is going to make you grow. Excuse me? They sent me a picture last night before I lay down of someone's back being torn to where their hip, they says their hip would be uneven. Got up, something was torn or pulled in my back, and I was leaning to the side. What they describe, they tell me they're going to blind me. Well, today they did, and every day they blind me more, and it's gotten where I can hardly drive. And these grown men get off on it. They tell me they come in my home and film me naked, and then spread it around it with each other in my town. They tell me they sell pictures. I mean, they're totally into degrading women. And then tonight they're saying, well, you can smile, but we bet you're suffering. You're so broken inside. They've been telling me I'm broken for over 10 years. And I just overlook them. The pain is real. The damage is real. They tell me now that they've given me cancer somewhere. They said the weapons they've been using lately will cause cancer. And I just can't understand how these people got this way, and how so many people in this country are broken. But a few things that I had to say today were about the sanctions. I mean, other people are allowed to talk about the news, not me. Other people are allowed to talk about God, not me. But there was just a video that turned up on news feed that everyone wanted me to see, and it was talking about the sanctions that Donald Trump and the Congress has placed on Russia. And it's just common sense. I just said, if they really rigged the election, why is he still president and they're being punished? I said that it makes no sense, because if you rig a beauty contest, are you going to punish the person that helps you win? And it shows their innocence right there. It's like setting someone up, because if you have no proof that a country did something, how in the world can you punish them? But if the vice president gave a speech and says, well, the only way we'll drop sanctions if Russia undoes what they did. Well, if they're accused of rigging the election, the only way to impeach the president, I mean, to undo it would be to impeach the president. But didn't he nominate the vice president? Now, wouldn't that be shooting himself in the foot? Do you see how crazy things have gotten in this country? And this person today says, well, you're going to miss me when I'm gone. And I'm like, I don't know you. And right after he said that I wouldn't accept him, you know, they started attacking my brain. Like, is he one of these people that's controlling these brain weapons? And they tell me crazy things like I'm going to be sacrificed to the devil. And if I don't give in to these people that are distilling my mind and raping my soul and taking nude pictures of me, it's just total lunacy and evil. But they sure can't stand it if I even mention President Putin's name. Oh, it's like he must be the light to them. I mean, he must be like the power that fights through the evil, because they are so afraid that I might like Russia, and they're so scared that I might spread some of Christ's words, or you know, say something from the Bible, or that I'm close to Christ. It's definitely demonic. And if you look at these people's evil and their foolishness, you see it's all destructive. And then you think to yourself that the demons in the world must be destructive, because they destroy peace. And right now, Russia doesn't seem to be in turmoil. If you look at their country, it seems pretty balanced. And they have all these new buildings going up and enrichment centers and churches. And how come the countries that are filled with the cuckoos are destroying their own buildings and destroying other countries through war? It's just something sick, is all I can say in the mind. I mean, sane people don't do this. And now I saw tonight where all these immigrants are being sent to Italy and Sweden and Norway just so they can destroy the people and the country.